Hello and welcome. Today we will hopefully be wrapping up the majority of the miscellaneous uses for my SSP particle-based arrow detectors, and we will start first with this small and simple modification of the detection area of my previous video's game detection mode. See, the idea with most arrow detectors is we don't know when the player is going to fire an arrow, and we don't even know if the player is going to hit the target. So we have to constantly be generating particles using something like fire or a torch or some other constant generation. But the idea now is that with our SSP detectors, we can just use snowballs instead, because we can fire them whenever we want, rather than having to wait for the player. And I wasn't really thinking about that because, frankly, I've just built way too many fire-based generators recently and didn't think about it. So, pretty simple. We just fire snowballs right here out of a dispenser at a wall on top of our pressure pad, and that'll just throw particles down. When we do that, we will also be firing an arrow, and it'll be detected instantly. So if we just press that, instant detection. No more needing to worry about lots of repeaters. And I think next we'll move on to flood detection. So in this case, we want to detect when water is above our target here. So that can be a source block, or it can be a ladder block, you know, one that comes out of the source block, a flowing water block. And it's very simple. In the newer versions, we have our particles dripping down onto our pressure pad, and we can just detect it like any other particle. So whenever we get a drip coming down, and it might take a while sometimes, come on. There we go, detected. And that's pretty much it for that. So you can use it for various Easter eggs. You can use it to detect when your SSP home is flooded or something like that, from a creeper explosion. Who knows, maybe you're protecting redstone from water that might damage it. Of course, might be a bit too late by then. But lastly, we have our proximity detectors, and this is a player proximity detector only for SSP, and the idea is that it won't activate until we get close. There is a drawback, however, and that is it requires input, such as a button, to fire our arrow at the detector. After that, we have, I don't know, 5 minutes, maybe less, so you would want to use this when you're sure that the player, or yourself, if you're doing this for yourself, is going to be very soon in the vicinity of the next puzzle, or, you know, whatever you're activating here. So, if we just press this button, we will fire an arrow at our detector there, but if we're too far away, you can see that the fire is not generating particles. It is not generating particles through the pressure plate, so it is not being activated. But the second we move too close, it will be generating particles, and therefore it will detect the proximity of the player to the detector and then activate the torch here to turn it off so we can make sure it worked. So if we walk too close, it generates particles. Those particles rise and activate our pressure pad up top, and that turns off our torch because it's finally been activated. And just like any other fire-based detector, you have maybe no idea when the smoke is coming up, so you don't want your player to be too far away, you don't want your detector to be too close to a wall or whatever. What I mean is you want your proximity to be wide so that they don't immediately step out of the proximity as soon as they enter. And next I'll take you through a sort of quick simulation dungeon. Not the best dungeon. I would advise using a bit more fail-safe puzzles, but regardless, I'll take you through that real quick. So, here we go. Alright, sorry for talking a bit fast back there, but anyway, what we have here is basically just an introductory chamber for our simulation dungeon that only serves one purpose, and that's to prime our next chamber with a arrow in its detector. So, I believe the answer to this puzzle for most people will be 42. Then we got the door open, we got our detector primed down below with an arrow. We can fill this pool up with water. And if we're lucky, we won't have to wait too long. And there we go, little decoration comes down. We'd have to wait a while otherwise, but then that primes our next room. So we walk in here. Suddenly everything turns black. I don't know what's going on. Suddenly chickens and wheat. What is this magic? I don't care, we have chickens and wheat. Then we just gather their attention. Come on, ignore the light. There we go. Jump up here. Chickens can't climb up here, but they can if we press this pressure pad. And then we just need to get one to fall in. Into that hole there. There we go. And then freedom! But if you kill all your chickens, or you waste all your wheat, we can press this button here, which will reset our detector outside. By throwing the sticky piston down, pushing our arrows out of the way, and then firing another arrow into our detector. And if you want to see how the rest of the redstone works, you can check it out yourself, because I will upload this map. But otherwise, I will see you next time.